choosing the type of potter's wheel to use, applying his choice of material, it was essential to consideration for avoiding any diminished or loss of integrity of that experience would occur. This concern led to his choice of the throttle wheel. His choice of this particular type of wheel over the many other available types of wheels focus on the strict adherence to the concern for maintaining the purity of impulses of life, energy that he wanted to enter the emerging form. The movement of the potter's foot on the kick bar is the sole source of power driving the energy for the emerging form in clay. In this way, the direct line connecting life and the potter maintains its purity. The movement of the kicking bar of the wheel by the potter's foot also joins in rhythm with the pulse of his life. Thus, it joins with the living form of his creation. Excuse me, let me back up. The movement of the kicking bar of the wheel by the potter's foot also joins in rhythm with the pulse of his life. Thus, it joins with the living form of his creation. In this way, the harmony between human and nature, that is beauty, is created. Possession of a living form in clay in itself does not provide an assurance that experience of life will follow. Just as in nature, the existence of a sapling in soil does not assure that it will survive and grow into a mature tree. The condition for that to take root and flourish is dependent on the elements of life. As in nature, the experience of the contemporary life in the art of the potter is dependent on certain conditions. Such conditions are those which are receptive and responsive to the energy that carries with it the experience of life. For some, this experience may occur very quickly. For others, a longer period of time will be needed. For some, it may not happen.